Turn to ban.
All right, gang, we're loaded in. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to more of the Mars TV Dota 2 League 2016. It's the MDL, and we are in the winner bracket final. It's Evil Geniuses going against NewB. I'm Kyle Guy for Beyond the Summit. I'm going to be joined by Merlini. Merlini, here we go. The two teams that have yet to drop a series against anyone here in this tournament, now squaring off, and probably some of the most MMR you'll see on the planet. I mean, where you're talking like at least three different 9K MMR gods in this game alone. So, a wealth of talent. What's your early impressions? Who's taking it? Who do you think looks like they've gelled a bit better, a bit sooner, and is kind of, you know, adapted to the meta that's been before us?
I think EG's been a little bit more impressive, but I'm still sad that there's no player intros.
Yeah, we were here, guys. We were waiting. We were watching the Chinese stream in hopes that we could see specifically the greatest player intros, Evil Geniuses. I was really let down when they showed some of the other teams, and they just weren't as fun. I think I saw, like, FY with a big toy gun. That was kind of neat, but outside of that, they were actually all taking it super serious. Did you see when, it was actually last night after our cast, they did it again for those teams, and OD played the Friends theme over it? It was phenomenal. I recommend checking it out, but it's so well. That was the best part of the whole thing, so we might have to take that for a future tournament. Nonetheless, this is going to be a very, very hot and heavy matchup. The winner of this is going to go right into the grand finals and just have a little bit of time off, because just waiting it out for the lower bracket final tomorrow, and then moving on to that best of five. So let's break down the draft before us here. NewB had the first pick, and they opt for the Shadow Demon. EG go right back for the Oracle and quickly pair it together with the Elder Titan. And, you know, we're giving a lot of credit to Crit with EG's performance yesterday. It feels like he's been doing a pretty good job filling in where PPD had left it, because, you know, he's kind of new to the whole leadership drafting role, and you got a name like Evil Geniuses above you, there's going to be a lot of pressure there, and he's been stood up, man.
I've met him in person. He doesn't really seem like the type of guy to really get nervous or really be pressured that much. I even played a brief stint with him and played with him a bunch in in-house leagues. He's just, like, you know, super quiet, a little reserved, and just, I don't know, just plays Dota, concentrates on the game.
Half really the people on this team, you'd be lucky to get four words out of, to be honest with you. Like, Universe, Zai, Crit. I'll go in there and go, what's up, guys? Like, hey. Hi.
Sumail too.
Apparently he's coming out of his shell a bit. So your best bet is Arteezy, if you want a, you know, a long, girthy conversation, but whatever. It doesn't matter, because where they do their talking, that's in the game, right, Merlini? That's all that matters.
Yeah. Their head's in the right place.
Yeah.
So Crit has been really liking the Oracle. Like, I think he picked it in
both games, I'm pretty sure. There were
three yesterday.
Yeah, at least two of them. I had it up here, let's see.
I think it's especially good versus the Chinese teams that they've been facing, because how often they do like the bat. I think it's a much better, like, people talk about Oracle being a counter Darkseer, which I don't really think is, it may be in the lane, but overall game it's not that great. But versus the Bat Rider, it's like one of the more difficult things to play around.
It's all aspects of the game, really, with Batrider too. His whole kit and caboodle with the lasso, and even in the laning phase, you're purging off all that sticky napalm.
And you, like, Fate's Edict, like, you can have, like, 20 stacks on you, you won't take any damage.
Yeah, Oracle can definitely be a crucial piece, and something that EG are probably always going to want to try to snag up. As mentioned, a lot of the Eastern teams put a lot of favoritism onto the Batrider and trying to snag it up early for themselves, but unless they're banning out the Oracle, it's not going to be a good time. They do respect ban and ban out the Huskar. EG did pick it up yesterday in their Game 2 matchup against Secret, but they did lose that series at the end. Remember, they were like on the verge of being able to take the series. They were going into the base, and then Arteezy got bursted down, and that's when the whole momentum from the Huskar just began to fall apart.
They had a lot of physical damage that game. This game, they don't really have that much physical damage, so it's a little bit more worrisome if you have to deal with a Huskar.
And can another concern be because, like, they've already committed now for what looks like their support duo, Oracle and Elder Titan. Elder Titan certainly can be good at holding the lane, being defensive, and dealing a bit with the illusion gaming. But I was just going to get ready to say, is that good enough? And EG say they want a bit more, so they move on to the Sand King. Now you have the Caustic to help with the illusion game, and obviously can be a potent offlaner and against a lot of these safe lane melee cores, and in particular, something newbie loves to go for, Sand King will be there to answer it. And you get team fight because they didn't have much of that already.
And an initiator.
And an initiator.
It kind of just gels everything together. The axe was already banned out. It's not terribly great versus the Shadow Demon anyways. They went with the Pace of Void yesterday, but the super long cooldown on the initiation really seemed to slow down their momentum, and Sand King, I think, kind of fits the pace for the type of style of game that they want to play. Ready to fight at any time.
Well, as they move into some bans in the second phase, EG had already got rid of some of the top pickups to go with that Shadow Demon, including the Luna, and then banning up the Sven. As we know, Sven is a great core to have, certainly when you're going against the Elder Titan and that natural order is ridding of all your armor. It'd be so nice to have the Warcry to be able to have a natural capability on just buffing yourself and your team back up, but they'll have to reach somewhere else for that. I don't know if it's someone who'd be like a typical AC candidate or a Lifestealer. Actually seems to be the choice here. State no newbie how Lifestealer either. It's going to be the U9 special, I'd imagine. He's been playing this pretty frequently, I'd have to say.
Did not expect a Lifestealer.
I mean, no natural, quote, vehicle yet for him, unless they have to fly into some sort of, like, puck or timber saw or some way. You know, he needs some way to kind of, you know, obviously get in and out of the fight.
He's one of the better melee heroes to deal with a Sand King in the lane. But he's going to have a hard time sticking on heroes, I think.
Yeah, you don't want to be just popping off your rage any sort of little skirmish, and when you have Oracle shooting out disarms like Fate's Edict onto him, you don't want to have to fall back on your rage just to be able to participate in fights.
I'm more surprised that they didn't go for the Jug, though. I think like the Jug is a much more standard pick versus like if you want a safe melee, safe laner. And I also think he's like better in the case that you probably want to make Shadow Demon's illusions of him, but
Well, EGC the Lifestealer, and they know that the man fight would be there, so they get one of the best preparations for it. Slark is one of the best at being able to go toe-to-toe, and with the benefit of a Shadow Dance, it's certainly not going to be easy for the Lifestealer to close anything out in a 1v1. So it could be a bit of a tricky time for him. And for the Slark's laning phase, I mean, as it looks right now, we don't know who his opponent could be, so options could be there from newbie if they want a way to maybe stunt the Slark in his laning phase or just pose a heavy aggressive lane altogether. But in the meantime, newbie gonna ease themselves into a Storm Spirit grab now. So they got their mobility, they got a way to jump into the back lines and maybe take down some of the pesky supports, including an Oracle, who's trying to be there as a get out of jail free card. But overall,
yeah, now the Lifestealer pick makes a little bit more sense. Because
vehicle.
They weren't going to pick Batrider, not versus Slark and Oracle. I think that would just be an incredibly difficult Batrider game. And then, like, Puck, they don't really seem to favor too much. I haven't seen them pick it in their earlier series. So, Quap, not really too in style nowadays. But they already have instant stun with the Sand King and a lot of burst for him. So, it's not a free Storm Spirit game.
Alright, gotta get rid of some of these remaining prominent offlaners, so that includes the Faceless Void here, for once not in the hands of EG. What is left out there that could still be able to match up, and if newbie decide to put it in the, you know, just traditional offlane spot, it would have to deal with the Slark quite a bit.
Beast.
Is Timber a bad option?
Timber's alright. I don't really think they need more utility, though, than the Timber Soul. I also think, like, he's going to have a hard time dealing with the ET and the Oracle, but he is very, very good versus Slark, and also very tanky versus the Elder Titan. I think if they wanted to, like, pick him and then go the Hood route, that'd be pretty nice. I think Beast is a little bit more solid, though. I think they're gonna be at a huge deficiency in the vision game. The Nyx, sometimes you'll see paired with the Lifestealer and the Storm Spirit as well, although there's not really a great great hero.
What about Slardar?
Slardar is decent. I actually like Slardar probably the most.
Yeah, you get your helpful amp damage, the vision on Slark. You get your Initiator. Someone who can really kind of get up in the grill of EG. Oh, they go for the Tidehunter though. And with that, we'll be able to have another kind of strong Initiator to kind of set the stage for the big team fight. They were only falling back on the Kunkka for any sort of respectable AoE team fight with that boat, but now Tidehunter adds a bit on top of it, and the final grab for EG, the Sukulele Templar Assassin, Ben. Should be a doozy. He's looking to go all in on just crushing down the Storm Spirit, similar to what we saw yesterday when he played that OD. That was devastation, and he rolled through the whole game from there, looking to do a bit of the same with the TA. That paired together with the Elder Titan, and you can just kiss your armor goodbye.
Yeah, I think EG's lineup is a lot stronger. Even though the Tidehunter does provide a decent amount of AoE, I think like the Oracle can pretty much just false promise anyone. As long as the Storm Spirit doesn't get too out of control too early, then the Oracle should just be able to sit back, and the threat from the other heroes should be able to like overwhelm Newbee in a team fight. I also think they have slightly better lanes.
We'll see if that is going to be the case or not as we do get underway. It is EG versus Newbee, your upper bracket final best of three matchup. We are already starting with the sound pause, unfortunately, here. Do I obviously apologize ahead of time if there is any sort of lag bumps or hiccups. Of course, we're working with best we can between this awesome Chinese firewall, but if we need to reconnect, we'll do so. Nonetheless, I'm not seeing anything too fishy with who's taking what. Sai's already on the scene, sporting his wards.
Dude, there's all the fish heroes in this game. There's Little Fish, Slark.
No Naga, so.
There's Tide.
We're missing Stumpfish.
Yeah, we're missing Slardar too, I guess. But there's a lot of fish-related heroes.
There's a lot of fish here. If this was a battle in the river, I would believe they have the advantage, but.
They need like a ocean river.
An ocean river?
Vial.
Oh, vial. For those things? Yeah, nobody uses those.
Aren't they expired soon?
I don't know.
Or are they expired?
I had some. You mean to tell me that I'm not going to get to use them?
That's your fault, dude.
Oh, well. I guess I should play more if I won't even be able to use them in the first place. I wish the caster could just dub a vial in the game that he's casting. That way when it's like a big like rampage, I'll just dump a blood vial in the river.
You have to buy the item in the game to use it, though. You have to like buy it, you go into the river, and then use the item while you're in the river. It's like, that's so hard. Why can't you just like press a button like in your options or something? Why can't it be, I don't know. It just seems way too hard. I don't want to waste an inventory slot on this.
That's like three extra clicks. I can't do that.
I could be holding a branch.
Yeah. No.
Or a share tango. Or anything. Wards, smoke. If it were in like a seventh inventory slot, like the coal. Remember the coal?
Oh, yeah. Coal pops up like right above the airport or something.
Yeah, there's plenty. Use it more
there's
often.
Plenty of user interface real estate here. I'm certain they could plug in a tiny vial box, but again, not really. Just not doesn't seem to be used. There's lots of potential for quality BM though with these vials. They just seem to be missing out on, Ben. What color would quality say to you BM. Biggest BM? Is it chrome? A chrome vial? Red for blood?
Depends on what team you're against, I suppose.
I mean, if you're like OG, ha! Green! Team green, let's go! We're OG! EG would be blue.
You'd be a great cheerleader.
Yeah! Blue vial, let's go, boys in blue! We got a murder problem over here, according to Newbee, but let me see, I want to dig up. Oh, Jack had a funny story, actually. So if you guys didn't see earlier, Jack was doing some of the interviews there in English. We saw one with him in S4. He's like our correspondent, if you will, out in China. Sending us some pictures, sending us some stories, and some quality Chinese memes. Today he had said that, I guess nearby, there was some sort of wedding going on. And the wedding was like, yeah, the wedding was like near the MDL event. And OG was like in passing going to a shuttle. And someone from the wedding party, might have been the groom, saw OG and was like freaking out, and they like totally like ditched his whole wedding party and his bride to like go over to him. He's like, and he was like so like, oh, OG, that he didn't know what to say. So all he could say was, miracle. Not even on the team anymore, buddy. But hey, you know what? Good shot. He was so happy to see him. OG was super nice about it. And I think the Beyond the Summit Twitter even posted a couple of the pictures of that incident too. It was pretty funny. But it looks like we are going to have a game. We're going to get back underway. Monitors have been fixed. And we'll get the show on the road for EG versus Newbee.
Dude, they are spamming the crap out of the Sentry Ward. It's like, I want to farm this jungle.
Too bad.
He has Iron Talon, but where are the sentries? I see one on Kaka. Looks like he's going to head over there to D Ward. They had the Observer Ward set up way early, so they knew exactly where Zai had placed it.
Now the trick is getting over there and extracting it without too much trouble.
I don't know if he's going to make it in time, though, because he is returning to the mid lane to block for the Storm Spirit. So he has to block, he has to go over there, he has to kill it, and then he has to leave the area all by 30 seconds time.
And I don't...
is your mission, Kaka.
Oh,
they choose to accept
it to KBA, actually. So, it's been finished.
All right, well, job well done.
That's efficient.
So, with Newbee's efficient road, they're going to be able to take out that blocking ward, and KP will be a bit relieved here, but he's straight to the Eye of Talon, straight to the jungle, forget the off lane. It will be sacked, it looks like, by Newbee.
He has the backstroke equipped.
Nice.
Best taunt in the game, hands down.
It really is. Undying's taunt does make
second place.
Yeah, it does make quality competition.
Dude, the backstroke is way too incredibly good.
It's very, very, very good BM, just like the Vials. Here, mid lane Zai trying to be the bully here, wants to allow Sumail to skate his way into some early momentum and trying to force SC back a bit. This is a... like, who would you give the
bottom
edge?
Bottom lane Universe.
Uh-oh.
Gets caught in a Torrent combo after disruption.
Oh, he's trying to get back away with the help of a sound with a Fairy Fire, and it looks like he's good. Sidesteps the Torrent and is able to avoid being first blooded.
How did he not die there? Man.
It's Universe. We don't ask these questions.
That's a tough kill to dodge. He only has level 1 Burrow Strike, but Stealth Shield, Fairy Fire, and Salve. It's a lot of gold expended, but better than giving 400 gold away of Newbee.
Kaka, disappointed with not getting First Blood, sacrifices himself to the Great Neutral Creeps and will take the trip back to the base and look for new opportunities elsewhere. That seems to be a mid lane where they're going to be doing a little bit of that bottle abuse. Fills it up for him, hands it off, and Kaka can look for the 2-minute rune. So everything happens to work out nicely, but Zai will spot him out. Doesn't want to let him get there. Can he get the stomp? Can he stop him? No.
He doesn't have a stomp.
Too fast.
He was looking for the chicken, actually. So the death by the Kunkka actually perhaps might have saved him from a chicken death. Who's going to get the rune? Ooh, that's a nice rune.
Nice and blue, and now in the pocket of SCC. C, as he takes it back to the mid lane.
Did you forget how many C's and U's are in there?
I'd rather say that than S triple C, to be honest, so...
just I'll... pronounce it phonetically. Okay, I regret
I'm just gonna
that.
Say SC, that's what we're gonna do before. The Storm player, mid lane, his CS matchup right now is 8-3 to Sumail's 15-5. That's right, Sumail's doubling up the CS game. We've seen this once before, and it did not bode well for the opponent of EG. And I don't know how much they're going to be able to do, because we also have Universe building up the ancient camps too. So there's going to be a lot of money funneled the way of Sumail for that big power peak in the mid game.
Just checking out Zai's movements too. He's only level 1.
Yeah, he'd been hanging around, flirting around that mid lane a lot, so yeah. Obviously not looking to get too close to steal the XP away.
That's why Storm's so far behind, though. It's because the Elder Titan's in park there.
Yep. And they also have the benefit. Arteezy's pretty much had the free lane up to this point. Kaipi's back now, but he had been mostly hanging out in that jungle. Newbee's wards, man, are all down this mid lane. They have straight vision all the way down the river right here, and if EG were to wrap up and around anywhere inside the woods, it would still remain in the dark. But
yeah. Well, they know they're not going to make a move on the Lifestealer. That's just... there's no
that's
way...
that's so far down there. That's
it's
too
so far.
So far
down there, and near impossible hero to kill at this point, so they don't really need any of the help down there. It's all about protecting the Storm Spirit, because he's the one that's really going to enable your team to do things, and of course, making sure KP gets a little bit.
Okay, stun out on Universe, but Faith is here with the disruption. Torrent's gonna be able to connect, but he goes right for the TP. They got the X though. Universe is making it to the fountain, but quickly returning. Burl though is gonna be there, but the right click will follow him. SD gets that grab and draws first blood for Newbee.
He used a stun very aggressively early to get that regeneration rune.
Faith was just at the right place at the right time to assist on that one. Newbee just, you know, obviously, just as we were talking about, you don't have to worry too much about the lifestealer, so these supports can casually move on through, getting some solo XP, working with the jungle pulls, and be nearby for those runes, just in case an opportunity like that does present itself. Arteezy feeling pretty aggressive here. Going back behind the tier 1, getting some free shots in on KP.
Trying to push him out of XP range.
Yeah.
From this creep wave. It's three range creeps right there, so you really want to deny him there if possible. And it looks like they're going to be able to do so. The wraparound.
Stomp comes in from Zai, and they'll get the job done. U9 shows up from the bottom lane. Him and Kaka looking to get some revenge right here. Faith in the front. Looks like they might have to settle for the Zai takedown. They will be able to get it with the next pullback. They'll get a little bit of redemption, but obviously the juicier pick being that Tidehunter grab for EG. And they did pull a lot of rotation and pressure from Newbee to that top lane.
That really hurts, losing those three range creeps. And on top of that, they had to get a couple of TPs. Like, EG really wanted that kill. They used a scan on the neutral cam to check out whether or not he was Iron Taloning before they made that move over to the left side of the map. And finally, Universe can get some levels. He was level 2.
Oh, mid lane! Nice stomp connection here. They're going to be looking for the crushing blow. Can they get the finish on SC? He's got his level 6, though. He quickly puts the point onto the ball lightning, and he gets a little bit of space, turns it back and around, gets the kill on Zai. Heads up play right there from Newbee. Allows him to get the turnaround pickup on not just the support, but it looks like they are still going to get a grab on Zumail. Oh, it was all for SC. Can they get him? No! He survives. What a dangerous player. Man, he just held on to the last moment to be able to put that point into the ball lightning and jumped just away from trouble.
That level 6 timing could not have come at a better instance.
Very unfortunate for EG, but a blessing for Newbee on that one. That just really helps out. That whole stunted start where he was getting bullied by Zai and was missing out, that will certainly make up for it.
Their supports are doing a really nice job of moving around the map and making sure that the storm is thriving. From the observer wars that we saw earlier, the Kunkka second time refilling his bottle this early, making sure that the chicken doesn't get killed, just really ensuring that he can be big.
All right, we got more stacks, or more attempted stacks here by EG, but as we can see, there is a sentry ward blocking that. So if Zai was keeping count of the camps, maybe he would see it, but nonetheless, still lots of money there for Sumail to fall back on and farm up.
They also really need the XP, I think, on the ET, because ET is only level 3.5 right now. Sinking's a little bit behind in levels, but he can easily do the jungle very easily with his Quelling Blood.
And you know, all the meanwhile, Corus continue to farm. Now, I did participate in that little skirmish earlier in the top lane, but Arteezy has been pretty diligent with his own farm in the top lane, so he's earned highest CS and top net worth. And I imagine looking to kind of push on forward. Are we just going to expect the cookie cutter build up for the Slark? Go right to the Shadow Blade and find opportunities to get the jump on your storms, on your supports?
I'm not sure. The Shadow Blade versus Blink is generally a pretty tough call to make. I think Blink might be a little bit better here, so he can jump on the back line.
Mm. We'll have to see what the call might be.
Yeah, but Shadow Blade would give him, I think, already a huge vision advantage. Combine that with the TA traps and the Spirit from the Elder Titan, I think they can almost always get the jump on the Shadow Demon.
Yeah, that's the thing. I mean, vision advantage is certainly there for EG between those traps and in between the Elder Titan Spirit.
Make sure that secure the stacks though, on both sides. That is, EG already had an observer planted on the ancient stack that is set up for KP. However, it's not capable, EG can take it, but great one power up, that was really hard on them. Flip side, you'd be sealed with the Tidehunter if they made that mission, because that's more likely. quickly because it's not protected by tower, and I think a Storm Spirit Lifestealer combo into one and kill, backed up by Ravage, I think they can control stack very easily. They don't have any vision in that.
Yeah.
Meantime, the grind of farm continues until they do that kind of start up, or probably a battle over that you bank between ancient camps. U9 close to the finish. Arm continues to be that babysitter right by his side. His eyes look good at separation now. He's dropped the tree, so he might be looking to attack sooner than later. While mid lane Kaka is going to see in a storm being able to go back to the fountain because while he's in the fountain, Kaka does get down mid lane. Rotations are coming in newbie. They look like a plus build up. They're looking to go for here.
I'm surprised Smith doesn't have more traps map. Really important moment, this new top rune. Doesn't have any mid lane. Doesn't have any ancients.
Okay, bottom here, we got a smoke ports here creeping in. They have U9 dancing under the tower versus nearby. But yeah, for Sand King, close enough south to be able to spot out the smoke, and you're not going to have to go for a pick. And obviously, would love to get make it a lot easier for them to find opportunities for that. But, stop, wait. 4 to 1 score now. We're only about 10 minutes. Things a bit slow. EG running to take over the lane between the start, mid lane, and with KP kind of just abandoning it, allowed the RTZ Slark to really bulk up quite a bit. But,
smoke.
Yeah. Since then, we have been off here. Dire's top tower is under attack. Made possibly from behind. Kaka makes a brief return from the base, but as they're getting pushed up for a push in the bottom lane, EG around. Top tower is under attack. They're not advancing yet, though.
They're
totally flanked from sides.
They're checking out how many are there. Oh,
we smoke. It's gonna get a clean shot right there. Sides move on in, and they have three on three matchup here between both sides. Earth Splitter flying out both together. To get first power off. Red looks like they might be able to get the ball on the outside. They should through it. They should bring down. Stuff will come in. And he gets the rush on it. While Faith will be able to get the. Looks like.
They have a run. Got a wrap. Stack. The meat now. I actually think this will work for newbie.
Eventually, Zai did make it out there. We had to wait a bit for the mana, but, you know, for from Zai, it only ended up being a Oracle. Then, team playing, respecting each other and those movements, and we have to really see our true team play.
Man, I understand. Very new vision on the Zai. Spirit. He didn't go for the boring early. He's still like well on his way to the bluster.
What is going on?
I don't know. The storm like is hurting my ears right now. I don't know. Okay, well, I'll help out a bit. He free hanging right here, but there's more stack game. Kaka, just a huge. I assume already worked through that. Right over the blink dagger.
Oh, it would pop. Combo. Like, a lot of times they're going to be disrupting, and he can just blink out of it, no problem.
Yeah.
Normally, he has a poison.
Ratchet! One of the great tools ever, yeah. Be able to make take damage. So.
Not that he should. Watch and be like that. They really need to look down and make some dumps. RTA was also very might could have gone a lot harder on the shame had he had enough mana to Shadow Dance in the middle of the fight. But now he's picking up the remnants of the Echo Saber, but still struggling a little bit. And EG really take a fight. The rap better. Ready to roll. mech.
Yeah.
Just daring. Dealers, but target. You're gonna have to be able to stun him before rage. If he rages, it's over at that point.
They are pretty. Yeah, they're prepared for this. They move right to the mid lane, they smoke, and they look to go right into their woods, and they're gonna spot at where EG are and make an approach. Let EG spot him just in front. And he will be able to come out another from Flint is to get all the pace.
Yeah, he has just been crushed the team fight. Mana for that. Well, jump. They still have threat ravagers, though. They do not want to fight into that. Well, but at they just get free kills.
He cannot afford to go. He is so close to that link dagger. Is he gonna limit? This is gonna be a real tough escape. Got the X to pull back. Mark's gonna be there. Should probably threat. So he will. Universe.
Didn't he have money for it?
No, I mean, he was just like 2,000 gold. He just still like.
It was gaming. Don't remember.
Unfortunately, that's the timing. He's still gonna have out for the here. Four, but it's too late. Before I've been able to swell up a bit. Mech timing coming online now. Go. They feel like they're the more confident team to kind of get any sort of 5-on-5.
Dire's bottom tower. They're not playing a pedal. Just very Slark community not giving EG any quarter or slowing down their timings with the on the blink. But he does he's setting on side for
rushing on it's the first for the S1 counter KP to those top little mix gonna be going in. Go for a key. Crit has in trouble. Look like they dish out the false promise to keep him alive, but they have enough firepower and they're gonna go ahead and chunk him down. Three. And not male makes it fair to get some big. Finish, does he? No! He's gonna board for his life. He's gonna be able to survive. Meanwhile, is gonna be crushing on. Looks fourth trade at the end of the day. I can't put that week based on the lag. Yes. Get to hold on to their U9 life dealer.
Submail on cleanup duty.
Yeah.
And now he has his Dezo. Now things are going to be a lot more threatening. Especially if they don't have.
Thank you.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Radiant structures are fortified. Radiant's middle tower has fallen. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
I'm just enticing Newbee in.
It's just not a great position for them. Because they're like all pushing up into that high ground, and like both of the backliners died. Storm Spirit and Lifestealer jumped the Elder Titan, and then TA jumped the Shadow Demon. So both of the teams were a support down very early on in the fight, but it ended up being no big team fights ultimate used. The Tidehunter wasn't in a good position. He really needs his Blink Dagger, but they're struggling a little bit to keep up with the farming pace of EG. Bloodstone came out around 19 minutes. The Blink Dagger, albeit a very fast-paced mech, will be a rather slow Blink Dagger for him.
What do you think about this grab? Sumail's going for the Hurricane Pike, it looks. Or he's got a 4-step for now. And then, I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah, right? Okay.
They want to, I think, save heroes from the Lifestealer. That's one of the best counters versus the bomb. If you can get enough in time. I false palm is better,
but yeah, Crit looks to be going for the mech buildup on the Oracle, taking advantage of the double burst to heal between false promise and then popping that Crit will pretty much bring anyone back to insta full.
Slark was Arteezy was really far up because of the Oracle. He yeah. Shadow Dance. You know, he I think he did get false promise, but he was just taking way too much damage at that point.
Yeah, obviously a phenomenal tool also on the Slark with this ridiculous amount of regen.
Yeah, he needs to be able to tank more though. Like EG, they don't have a hero up that can just like get in the middle of the fight. It has to be like TA moving around the edges of the fight, looking for easy targets, like tanking, hiding in the fog, needing to get up at epicenter, like, start going in, blowing his defensive cooldowns early. Like none of them can really stand up. They can't like pressure Newbee to ravage early on in the fight. Like, he doesn't really feel he has to save anyone. They have defensive disruption, they have rum, they have mech, they have, like, all their heroes are, like, very tanky, even without any items, because they're defensive spells.
Yeah. And, EG have been kind of blessed with opportunities that, you know, they've take good enough fights where it's kind of fended off Newbee, not where they walk away like kind of teen wiping or anything, but they're able to kind of dish out what's necessary to match up even. And if they're banking on taking this one a bit longer and playing with the clock a bit more, I mean, wish kind of granted here. So they're going to be able to kind of get Sumail to that next big point, but I imagine with time wasting away here on the Aegis, they're eventually going to look to make their advancement. Looks like the bottom lane is going to be in order here. They have one more tier 2 to bring down, it looks like, in the mid lane. Oh, actually one more here at the top. So, lots of time to work on forward. And I don't know if Newbee want to be already stuck in a position where they don't comfortably move out anywhere to farm.
Oh, they're going to be in that position soon because yeah. They just picked up on the side of EG. So, they have the gem. They're just going to control the map and wait for next Rosh. I think if they get Storm Spirit and Aegis, I think they will like lose out really hard in the next 10-15 minutes of that game, especially if that leads to Roshan number 3, because the Storm Shearer will just go absolutely nuts. He hasn't died yet with his Bloodstone, and then if they give him Aegis, he's gonna have like 20 charges or something like that. So I think, like, at all costs, they have to prevent that from happening and just play very carefully around their side of the map and don't take unnecessary risks and just wait for Sumail and Arteezy to get really, really big and SCC to eventually fall down to their damage.
SCC picks up a regen run. Okay, he is getting closer to that Orchid being complete along with that Bloodstone he already sports. They see EG here in the bottom lane. EG plant down a ward, get a push in the bottom, and pull on back out, looking to kind of just sidestep themselves away from any sort of newbie pressure.
They need to take the gem. They bought the gem like a minute ago, but they haven't actually given it to anyone. Maybe they're waiting for a better carrier. I don't know. Sark's not going BKB, so it's not like he can carry it because he seems to die often in the fights. And you don't want it to give it the supports because it'll just get jumped by the Storm Guard and Lifestealer. Is very slot limited and will likely need the slot for an Aegis. So I don't know who they're going to give it to. It's a tough call overall, but you don't buy the gem and then just park it in your base. Unless it's like a super long game, like a 70 plus minute game where the 10 minute timer actually is going to matter.
I don't know if they're holding it in hopes that, you know, once it's about Rosh time, they just use it to sweep the whole area and get rid of all the wards, get the vision down yourself, and then take it. For now, though, obviously just waiting to snag it up on the courier and put it to whoever placeholder they got.
Yeah, I thought they would have sweeped the top part of the map. Like, if you're ward-busing it, I can completely understand that. But they've had moments where they could, like, sweep their side of the map. Not that they probably think any of that wards. I don't know. Go with solo pushing out the top lanes, so they probably do expect that there were some sort of wards up there.
EG need more time, it looks like. They got a lot of reactive kind of arm items coming into play now after Universe was able to finish out his Yule Scepter. It looks like he could be on way to also putting it together with a fourth staff himself. So that together with already Sumail's Hurricane Pike. Looks like he's got a BKB which should be done in just a few moments. And
but the storm's gonna be really big. He has Bloodstone Orchid. And now he's just like, they only have one stun for him at this point. And let's say like they false promise the target, then they'll just immediately jump at the Oracle because he doesn't have any items at this point. And I foresee the storm being a pretty big problem. Maybe like TA can get a big crit on him though.
I mean, there is a Yule's. If they can catch him with that into his stomp, could find himself in a little bit of trouble. But you're right, if he's
that's just the storm alone, like with that with boat, like they're just
deep commitment a little bit here to go for Sumail, but he gets quickly his force off, and now they've been able to spot out Zox, so that's when they're gonna make their commitment, and they quickly execute him. Zai gonna get dropped, they're getting respectable damage onto SC, but EG recognize that all of NewB are here on deck, and they do not want to risk crossing with them when they are not prepared, so they'll suffer the loss of their Zai support, lose the tier 2, and EG will just split the difference, add pressure here in the bottom lane. Vice Universe and Arteezy will look to clear out this tier to the top lane. Drawing Newbee back and away.
Just respawned. EG could possibly sneak it in at this moment as some of their heroes have TP'd off to the side lanes. And SCC looking to jump.
Down. Sees out Universe. Gets the pick.
I wonder who cleared those trees. He's probably cursing the player that did that because they gave him the Observer Ward Vision to jump him.
Oh, you're right. Right here. Very unfortunate for you.
It could have just been like the Lifestealer too. Who knows who it was, but
whatever it may be, it was enough of a brief glimpse for SC to be able to move in and out and eliminate the Sand King here. Universe will be out for 30 seconds. If EG were considering a move in on the Rosh, I would imagine that the Sand King is a huge factor.
Yeah, the source was already in that area though, so it would have been very difficult for them. He can just perch himself an edge, and they can't punish him for it, really. And they have really good vision inside the pit, too. Disruption illusions can be sent in. Shadow, poison, aside from the Storm Spirit himself.
I mean, something Sumail's pretty familiar with himself, though. I'd imagine they should be prepared for the Storm factor in this Rosh pit. But they have Elder Titan factor, so spirits will keep coming out and being a bit nosy here by NewB. Arteezy pushing in this top lane a bit, but NewB have made their move.
It's taken them way too long to push out this lane. Like, Sumail was the only one that was able to push out this. And they have the BKB on Sumail.
Oh, they're going to look to cut off EG here. They rush right up into him. EG's going to spot him, and they quickly try to spread. The Ravage will connect, but it's very far in between. But it doesn't matter, man. NewB quickly make their mark. They take out not one, but both supports already by EG, and EG have to pull back.
Yep.
I can't believe how fast they were able to get that jump, because EG kind of saw the approach. They spread as much as they could, unfortunately still getting hit by the Ravage, but...
That was a really good move.
But NewB were just like, nope, we see you. Get that guy, and they were both gone.
Well, KB pulled uphill. He just knew, okay, I see one of them. I know all of them are behind them. That gut reaction that you need from your initiator. KB trying to... Oh,
moving from Universe, he's gonna get snagged, he takes inches, but he's gonna be quickly forced to burn it here. RTZ all looking to intercept, help out a bit, while KB makes chase to Mail, and RTZ able to attack, he looked to go for SE, as he makes it to the low ground and makes it out. Universe on that second life, goes to the high ground, but SE's gonna go to the high ground and close him out. To Mail, facing three, possibly four, Bo's gonna be coming on in, but with the BKB, he's gonna be able to jump back out. Blinks behind, and Rondé's booze with the rest of his team. Oh my god, at the end of the day, Ben, the only person to drop was Universe both times with that Aegis.
Oh, SDC would have loved to have that. But...
That was a wonderful stop by EG and preventing NewB from getting that Roche done.
NewB, they still played that very well. Like, normally yeah. You'll lose a fight, I think, with the TA surprise BKB, because you're not completely sure if she has it. I guess she was showing at some point, but still, it's very, very strong versus the... Tidehunter, and then the Ghost Scepter pickup by Kunkka enabled them to kite the TA. The Storm Spirit was very careful about not exiting the pit too early. Sumail blinked back to try and kill him.
Oh my, SE jumps right towards Sumail. Sumail, though, has found his target and just quickly execute Faith. And now it's going to be NewB who are going to be forced to backpedal a bit.
Now with the Slark and the Basher, they actually have okay kill potential on the Storm Spear now. Like, he still feels pretty squishy, even despite him being a plate mail, because Sumail is just so farmed.
What is this? Kaka in a whole nother dimension here, back up and behind the EG plane. Alright, self goes. Torrent, boat, spate created from Kaka. Oh, he was somewhere else entirely. Got to learn what it looks like down in the middle of the river, but here we go. Hard committed by EG. Recognize an opportunity with one off the playing field. They want to make it go. A jumping from SC. It gets the blow up on the crit. I don't know how it happened, but there was a jump and then there was a death. So more of this back and forth. You take my support, I'll take yours. And it looks like, I don't know if EG are going to be feeling too comfortable not having that false promise. So.
Oh, TA is going for Bloodthorn. They want even more for the Spirit. And he has Shiva's.
Oh, jump in. Quick grab onto Zai, it looks like.
Yep.
Vision is there. It's actually over on the other side of the river, but... EG ping out and anticipate that maybe there was a NewB ward planted where Kaka was picked off. And 20-8 now. It does not feel like it's 20-8 for NewB, but... The net shows that EG are still winning the net worth right now.
Lifestealer is beyond godlike. Or actually, no, he's just gonna like.
9-0-4.
Yeah, he's been pretty quiet. Just been sitting inside a storm.
They are hard
kills.
To kill, man. These NewB cores between both of them only have died once.
Yeah.
AP's also only died once.
They've itemized correctly. Lifestealer going for a lot of armor. I mean, the armlet is standard, but. Both the cores picking up plate mails very early on to deal with the TA, and of course the Elder Titan with the natural order.
Here comes NewB towards the tier 2. EG just south of him and now looks to go in. RTZ gonna get into the silence and into the pulled in with the boat with the pressure. They're gonna kick him off. He can't get anything undone. And RTZ's gonna finish. Now they move on forward. Zai's gonna be forced back in out right now. Sumail looking to go into the mix. Tries to get the hit on Faith, but Faith with the self disruption will be able to survive. Unfortunately, on the bad end of SC is gonna get blown up. Then jump for the back. They're gonna get the grab on Sumail, pulling him in. Ooh, not continues his gun like tear. Going 11. 7-0, and now getting on the backpack of KP, allowing him to blink on in close to. They pop out the bomb, and they'll get the Zai down. 4 drop from EG, newbie loop nobody, and ascend now into the high ground to go for the 3.
Yeah, one downside to Martini's build is that he is just not very tanky at all. If they get to work on him before he pops his before he pops his pack of a Shadow Dance, it's over. And not to mention, Xiamen blinked into the trees and was stuck there because he didn't want to use his Hurricane Pike too early in the fight. And he was just very limited in his ability to do damage there. Storm Spirit controlling the fight yet again. SECC is out of control.
Woo, this guy is currently the second highest MMR in China. I think he's the second highest MMR in the game, actually. Now putting on a show for everybody with the Storm as he also looks to close things out with another pick here onto Universe. And eventually the Scorpion will drop and then be bombed out. 25 charges for him.
He's just played very cleanly on the Storm Spirit, not overextending, just being very patient about when and where he chooses to go. And I think like the way they approach the second Roche and kind of quelled EG's momentum. And right now, it just rests way too much on a Xiamen to do damage. He's like the only damage dealer at this point, but they have a lot of single target saves with 2 Ghost Scepters on the cores at the moment, the defensive disruption, and I think overall, like, the Kunkka Tidehunter combo is like a really big problem for EG. Like, they cannot last the duration of the boat. They need to be able to kill people very, very quickly, but when people are taking half damage and Ghost Scepter is coming out, like, you're getting the entirety of your BKB duration kited. And then if you don't pop your BKB, you'll just die in a Ravage or a Storm Pool or anything, pretty much. And Xiamen's the only one with a BKB.
Oh, man. I want to keep my camera locked on SC because it looks like he's like eagle up on a nest right now. And he's looking around for like little mice running along the grass field. So he's like, I found one! He jumps into Xiamen, but the mouse is fast and jumps on back, but then he spots a poor little crit rodent behind him. Is going to quickly take him out and bring him back to babies at home. And now they'll look for the follow-up kill. It's going to be Xiamen, a jump from KP lands, a nice Ravage. And before the fight can even conclude, Crit says, we're done here. We've had enough. Newbee will take game number 1, 28-8 at about 36 minutes in. Very polished showing.
A lot of it had to do with how well they flipped the Oracle. How, like, there were so few fights where I felt like the Oracle had an impact. He died a couple times early, but one of the signs of a support generally is that you can do a lot of stuff without items, and he just wasn't able to do anything. Like,